with these two best friends, one is black, one is white. And even though they grew up in the same neighborhood,
they're having
the same
very
friends,
different experiences.
They're having very different experiences.
Yeah.
And it's hard for them to even see the other person's full experience.
Yeah.
So I was so excited to see that portrayed in a movie because it's something I see all the time where even though, is his name Miles?
Yeah.
Even though he grew up in the hood, and look, I know white boys like that. Like, they grew up in the hood. They have more street cred than anybody, but he still has that white privilege that, like, maybe he can't see.
Yeah.
So how cool is that for you to just be a part of a film who's having that conversation?
Well, not just having the conversation, but really illustrating it in a very understandable, tangible, approachable way. And it also delivers this message at a moment when you love these characters so much that you're like, ready to receive it, you know? So few people have done that really well, and almost everybody feels it from both sides. You know, from people who experience white privilege, if they woke enough, they understand it. But it's very hard to articulate, and it's also a very new conversation. Ironically, as the generations go by, we're all going to be tan anyway. So it's going to be an obsolete conversation at some point, hopefully. But this is a really helpful movie because it can explain things that maybe you might be feeling that you've never seen before, you haven't been able to explain to yourself.